Netflix for you, Netflix for me. I've got Netflix running on a Raspberry Pi 3.
In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get Netflix running on a Raspberry Pi 3 natively. Now, that's no tricks, no streaming or anything like that. This is running right now on a Raspberry Pi 3. Stick around, because it's TechWiz time. Hey guys, Jonathan here with TechWizTime, where I teach you technology through tutorials. And today I'm going to teach you how you can get Netflix running on a Raspberry Pi 3. Now when I say running on a Raspberry Pi 3, I mean running, not streaming from another source or anything like that. This is natively running inside Raspbian on a Raspberry Pi 3. Now the reason why this is so notoriously difficult on a Raspberry Pi is due to DRMs and so forth. And there's one in particular called Widevine. And how this tutorial gets around that is by pre-compiling Chromium, which is a web browser, to work with Widevine. Now it only takes a couple of lines of code to actually get this up and running on a Raspberry Pi 3, so you're not gonna have to wait out for a 10-minute video of me just talking and talking about Netflix and how it could run or how it may not run or how you can get it streaming. Nope, this is just two lines of code and I'm gonna show you that right now. But first, I wanna get this video out to as many people as possible so they know how to get Netflix running on their Raspberry Pi 3. So if you can share this video on Facebook groups, Reddit, and other social media sources, that would be fantastic. And also if you could like and also comment on this video and let me know that you got it running yourself. So with that little bit of a plug out of the way, what we'll do is we'll jump over to the Raspberry Pi and I'll show you how to get Netflix running right now. So when I say simple, I really mean simple, but what you're gonna need firstly is you're gonna need your Raspberry Pi set up with Raspbian Pixel, preferably the latest version. And what you'll also need to do is have a keyboard and mouse handy because we're gonna be navigating the Raspbian operating system. So once you've successfully booted up Raspbian, what you need to do is you need to go up to the terminal window up the top. And when you've opened that, we're going to wget this file to the Raspberry Pi. Now I'll leave this link on the screen. I'll also leave a link down in the description below so you can copy and paste this straight into your Raspbian installation. So once you have downloaded that to your Raspberry Pi 3, the next step is you need to install it or get it all set up properly from the package. So to do that, you type in this command on the screen now. Again, this is written down in the description below. This will take a little bit, but once it is done, you're almost ready to watch Netflix because the first time you do it, you will get a Widevine error. Or Netflix saying that it isn't supported. So what you need to do is you need to give it a quick reboot. I have had some people need to reboot this two or three times to actually get it to sync in properly. But once it has worked, all you need to do is you need to go to the Raspberry Pi menu, go down to internet, and then select the Netflix launcher. Log in with your Netflix details, and lo and behold, look at that. We're streaming Rick and Morty.
It's the Rick and Morty show!
Okay, so with those two lines of code, you've now got Netflix running on the Raspberry Pi 3 natively. How awesome is that? So one of the things I did have is I did have a couple of crashes, but this was after about 11 episodes in of season one of Rick and Morty. So you can imagine, like, if I got that far into it, you're probably not going to have problems all the time. When it first starts out, because of the network connection, there may be a little bit of buffering at the start, but once it gets started, it works perfectly fine. I actually got through two seasons of Rick and Morty and it worked great. So do you have any problems getting this running or do you just want to let me know that you did get it running? Leave me a comment down below. If you're not a subscriber to this channel already, then make sure you hit that big red button because it really helps this channel a lot. And if you are a subscriber already, then make sure you hit that bell icon so you can get notified whenever I release a new video. Don't forget to like this video. And as always, imagine, learn, create.
This video is gonna be so quick. It's gonna be done in no time. Hey Morty, this guy TechWizTime, he finally got Netflix working on a Raspberry Pi 3. How awesome is that? Wubba lubba dub dub!